Welcome to the Django project, DJ Blogger. This tutorial is part of a YouTube Django project playlist, which you can access in the video description. You can watch the whole course from the very beginning. If you enjoy this course and would like all the updated tutorials and associated code samples and more, you can check out this course and other courses this project features at Udemy. The link to the course is in the video description. Before we finish this section of our project, I wanted to just give you some information regarding some tools that we can install to help support our development process. If you are new to Visual Studio Code, then you probably don't know about extensions. So on the left-hand side here, back in our project, we can see the extension tab here. And you can see that I've already installed one extension, that's Night Owl. So if you're wondering what theme this is, I've installed Night Owl and I've set the color theme to Night Owl, and that's what you're looking at right here. So there are hundreds of thousands now of different extensions that we can install with it, which will be useful to help us develop or speed up the development process. So one of them, particularly if we're working with Python, is the actual official Microsoft Python extension. So what we're installing here is essentially a set of tools which is going to help us support the development process while writing in Python. So it's going to provide such things as IntelliSense. So it's going to help us or identify potentially what it is we're trying to type and then automatically fill it in for us so it can speed up our typing, for example. Linting and debugging. So for example, it'll help us determine whether our code is correct or structured correctly and so on. So there's tools such as that, code formatting. So Python comes with many different standards. So we can utilize, for example, PEP 8, which is a formatting standard for Python, which gives us an indication of how Python should be presented visually. So these type of tools will be all bundled in here. And you can see it's very popular, 70 million downloads. So go ahead and install that. Now, when we install this, it doesn't just install one extension. It actually installs multiple extensions that are connected to this. And it's up to you whether you want to manage those or not. Most of the extensions won't be needed for this project related to other technologies relating to Python and different types of Python programming. So you can see that took quite a long time to work, and you can see that it's opened up some windows, etc. So we'll just ignore those. Let's go back to our extensions now. And let's get rid of our filter here or our search. And you can now see that there's a whole bunch of things that have been installed. Jupyter, XYZ, Pylance, and iSort. So you can remove the Jupyter extensions if you want to. They won't cause any trouble or anything like that. But it's completely up to you. We won't be using those technologies. So that's the first extension that you can install. Now, if you want a much more in-depth view of this, I have at the end of this course created some additional materials which you can utilize to get a more in-depth view of what this tool does and how it works.